NASA and its commercial crew program today announced new agreements with three American commercial companies to design and develop the next generation of U.S. human spaceflight capabilities, enabling a launch of astronauts from U.S. soil in the next 5 years. Advances made by these companies under newly signed Space Act agreements through the agency's Commercial Crew Integrated Capability Initiative are intended to ultimately lead to the availability of commercial human spaceflight services for government and commercial customers.
Our commercial crew and cargo efforts are based on a simple but powerful principle. By investing in American companies and American ingenuity, we're spurring free market competition to give taxpayers more bang for the buck, while enabling NASA to do what we do best, reach for the heavens.
Sierra Nevada Corporation will advance its Dream Chaser spacecraft, which resembles NASA's space shuttle but is smaller and based on improvements to the agency's HL-20 lifting body design. The company partnered with United Launch Alliance to launch its spacecraft atop an Atlas V rocket. SpaceX's crewed Dragon will get more lift capability from the next generation of Falcon rockets. The uncrewed version of Dragon recently made history as the first commercially built spacecraft to rendezvous and then berth with the International Space Station. Boeing will continue to develop its CST-100 spacecraft, which underwent rigorous testing during two previous commercial crew development phases. It too will launch atop an Atlas V.
I am very confident in the ability and capability of our three partners under ICAP. I believe that we can make great progress with these three partners.
Between now and May 31st, 2014, NASA's partners will complete their spacecraft and launch vehicle designs, test their hardware, and then showcase how they would operate and manage missions from launch through orbit and landing. The agency's CCICAP initiative sets the stage for a crewed orbital demonstration mission to low Earth orbit by the middle of the decade.
Well, welcome back. Welcome inside Mission Control. We're very pleased to be joined by Brent Jett. He is the Commercial Crew Program Deputy Manager. Brent's obviously no stranger to Mission Control, and obviously being on orbit as an astronaut, he's flown four times aboard the space shuttle, two of those actually to the International Space Station for assembly missions. He joined the Commercial Crew Program early last year in 2011, and prior to that he was the Director of Flight Crew Operations, which oversees the astronaut office and aircraft ops, which is located primarily out at Ellington Field here down the street from Johnson Space Center. Those four space shuttle flights seems like it probably been a long time ago now, but he first flew on STS-72 as a pilot, then STS-81 to the Russian Mir space station as a pilot, and then commanded two missions to the ISS early in the assembly phase, and then as we got started with assembly once again after the loss of Columbia, STS-115, your final flight was back in 2006, and then he transitioned into a management role. So, Brent, thanks a lot. Welcome to Mission Control. I know it's been a while since you've been here. Talk a little bit about how you segued actually into the role of Commercial Crew Program Deputy Manager, how that all got set up.
That's interesting. I was, as you mentioned, I was the Director of Flight Crew Operations in 2010 when the President announced the Commercial Crew Program. That was in February. Mike Coates came to me shortly thereafter and said, you know, we need somebody at JSC to work with Kennedy to set up the program, essentially in a planning office type of role. So he asked me to take that on as sort of an additional responsibility to being Director of Flight Crew Ops. So for the next year or so, I kind of wore two hats, working with Ed Mango in Florida to set up the program, and then also continuing on with my role as Director of Flight Crew Ops.
You know, Ed came by back about 5 months ago, I guess it was now, and talked to us about the state of the program. Obviously, a great deal has happened since that time frame. Now, he's based, the program's based at KSC down in Florida, and of course you're here in Houston, but you know, from my vantage point, it looks like that coordination's working really well, and you know, is that kind of a model for how NASA plans to do its business in the future, at least relative to commercial crew?
Yeah, I'm not sure it's necessarily a model that we're going to try to follow, you know, with all programs. It works. It's been working very well. I would agree with you. Kennedy and Johnson have I think unique and complementary skills in the workforce. Kennedy, as you mentioned, is the lead center. The program office is there with Ed leading the entire program, and what Ed has done is really made a concerted effort to ensure that people don't view this as just a Kennedy program. You know, he understands that it's going to take all the manned space flight centers, all the human space flight centers to make this program work. So, you know, I give him a lot of credit for making that happen.
How do y'all have the program structured in terms of, you know, division of responsibilities?
Yeah, it's a little bit different than what folks might remember from the shuttle program. You know, sometimes when you have a multi-center program, you take specific areas or projects and give that whole delegation to a certain NASA center. What we didn't really want to take that that path. So, what we've done is really every office within the program, almost every one of them has leadership that spans the centers and people
right.
working in the office that spans the center. So that's a little bit unique, but it's worked out well so far.
Now we're moving into the next phase, which is CCICAB, which stands for Commercial Crew Integrated Capability. We're winding down the previous phase, CCDEV-2. You talk a little bit about how that's now structured, the differences as we move into the next phase.
Yeah, I'd say there's probably two main differences. We didn't really restructure the program itself, but obviously we had 7 partners in CCDEV-2, 4 funded, 3 unfunded, with smaller teams working with each of those partners. And as we transition into ICAP, we have 3 partners now, and the scope of their work is much bigger. So they're working on the whole integrated system, and so the teams that we have assigned to work with each of those companies are larger.
Right, and you know, for those that haven't tuned in, we did have an opportunity to talk to the 3 partner managers. I'll call them new, but they're not really. They've all served in pretty extensive roles already within the CCP, but it was very interesting to hear how they're working on their new teams in terms of organizational activity. But obviously, with that, you know, what is your view of the external response from the companies themselves and how this is structured now?
Well, I think industry has been very positive throughout the whole commercial initiative. You know, it started back in with the COTS cargo initiative, and now it's been expanded to crew. So industry, I think, is very, very they're very pleased and very anxious to continue this model. I think they view the combination of NASA bringing their experience to the table, along with the freedom for industry to be innovative, move quickly, and have a little bit more control of their design. That combination, obviously, they find very attractive.
I know that one of the important things that you guys at the program are taken very seriously is the next steps, really, is risk and then certification or combined. And I know that that's something that's coming down the road, obviously, that you guys are working on pretty feverishly right now. Can you talk a little bit about how everybody's embracing that aspect of the structure?
Right, and I think it's good for folks to realize that the program up to this point has been primarily focused on facilitating industry and their development of their own commercial systems. And at some point in that process, we need to transition to a role of doing certification for the ISS mission that we need to get our astronauts to and from station. And we recently announced our strategy for how we were going to start that certification process. And we should, by early next year, we'll be in what we call phase 1 of the certification effort, where now rather than just facilitating the development of these systems, we're going to be going in and working with industry and these companies to ensure that what they're developing meets our requirements and our safety standards.
Budget stability is always a big part of this. And what have you heard? How are things in terms of the budget structure moving out in the next? Obviously, CCICAP is kind of laid out as a 21-month program, and then what's laid out beyond that?
Yeah, so you're right. Budget stability is a challenge for every program manager and their deputies and their team. So it is something we're working on. I think the way we've developed our plans, we have to be able to respond to changes in budgets year to year, and so we're ready to do that. But I think in the long run, ultimately, politically, I think there's a general agreement that we need a U.S. capability to take advantage of the space station. We only, relying on the Soyuz, we're single string there. Any problem with the Soyuz and if it was grounded for a period of time, we would be unable to get astronauts back and forth. So that and the fact that, the American taxpayer has invested a tremendous amount of money in the station, and we really want to fully utilize that, and commercial crew and cargo are both part of that. So I think there's general agreement that what we're doing is something that needs to be done and has a high priority, where I think we get sometimes a little bit skeptical, a little bit of skepticism on the political side because we're doing things differently. This is not your traditional development program, and as stewards of the taxpayers' dollars, I think rightfully so, we get asked a lot of hard questions. But since the cargo program actually spanned the previous administration, I think we're somewhat, hopefully we're somewhat apolitical in terms of not being tied to one party or the other. Both can claim responsibility for our success when we make it.
Right. Yeah, I understand. Well, I'll end and by number one thanking you for coming by, but I think I'll end with a question that you probably get asked a lot, and that is in your role obviously as an astronaut, but and especially with commercial crew, and that is, would you go fly on these new vehicles that are under development? I know you go out to these all these locations and now we're down to the three, at least in CCICAP, but Would you go fly on these vehicles?
Yeah, that's interesting. It's probably not the right question to ask an astronaut or a test pilot or probably a lot of the type of personalities that work here at NASA. We tend to be pretty much risk takers in general. But I look at it as my job is to, at the end of the day when we're getting ready to fly that first mission, is to be able to look in the eye of our NASA astronauts and our international partners and tell them that, we've done everything we need to do to ensure that the risk we're asking them to take is acceptable. And I fully expect we're going to be able to do that. And at that point, I'd feel comfortable putting my brother or my sister on the vehicle as well.
Yeah, well, I know we're all looking forward to it. Obviously, the station program is, because that's one of the destinations for the vehicles that are chosen to actually go and continue to fly. So we're all looking forward to that. So we'd like to thank you, Brent, for stopping by for a few minutes. I know you haven't been in mission control for a while, but
I wasn't sure my badge was going to let me in, actually.
But we really enjoy you coming by, and hopefully we'll have an opportunity to visit with you again soon. So thanks a lot.
Thanks, Kyle.
Brent Jett, the Deputy Program Manager for the Commercial Crew Program.